Welcome to Edukado Hub Network Analysis Lecture Series. In this lecture, we will go through various questions related on OHM'S law, KCL, KVL, and series and parallel operations. First question is, find the values of current through and voltages across all the branches. Okay. So, as we know that in series, voltage gets divided and in parallel, voltage remains same. But in parallel, current gets divided and in series, current remains same. Okay. With respect to that, let's assume that voltage across 15 ohm resistance is V15. Voltage across 10 ohm will be V10. Voltage across 5 ohm is V5. Voltage across 3 ohm is V3. And voltage across 2 ohm is V2. Okay. Let's assume that the current through entire circuit is I, then at that particular point, this point, the current will be divided into two parts. Let's assume that that part is I1 and I2. Okay. So, with respect to that, we will try to find out the entire voltage and current through each element. Okay. So, first of all, in such kind of problems, we have to find out the entire resistance first. Okay. So, let's find out the equivalent resistance of this particular circuit. So, this series network will be equal to 5 ohms. Okay. Now, first of all, we have to solve this particular network. Okay. So, this will be 15 ohms. So, we will have a network consisting 215 ohms resistances in parallel. So, 1 upon R equivalent will be equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 because both of them are in parallel. So, 1 upon 15 plus 1 upon 15 will be equal to 2 by 15 1 upon Req. So, Req will be equal to 7.5 ohms. So, you can either solve it in this way or you can go directly Req equal to R1 into R2 upon R1 plus R2. So, it will be equal to 15 into 15 upon 15 plus 15. 15 into 15 upon 30 equal to 7.5. Okay. So, entire resistance in this particular circuit is 7.5 ohms. Now, so equivalent circuit will be a resistance of 7.5 ohms is connected to a 3 ohms and a 2 ohms resistances in series across a 20 volt voltage source. Okay. So, if I will solve this particular network, I will get a 12.5 ohms resistance across volt power supply. Okay. Now, so current flowing through this circuit will be 1.6 amps. How? As we know that I equal to V upon R. So, V is 20 volt and R is 12.5 ohms. So, 1.6 amps, okay. So, 1.6 ampere current is flowing through the circuit. As you know that the current in series remains same. So, 1.6 ampere current will be flowing through 3 ohms as well as 2 ohms, okay. So, voltage across 3 ohms will be equal to 1.6 into 3. I into R will be equal to 4.8 volts and voltage across 2 ohm resistance will be equal to 1.6 into 2 will be equal to 3.2 volts. Okay. As we know that this 20 volt is divided between these three parts. So, voltage across 15 ohms resistance will be equal to 20 minus 4.8 minus 3.2. 20 minus 8.0 will be equal to 12 volts. So, current through 15 ohms, which is I15, let us assume I15 will be equal to 12 upon 15 will be equal to 0.8 amps, and current through this 15 ohms will be equal to I10 and 15 will be equal to 1.6 minus 0.8 equal to 0.8 amps. Okay. So, 1.6 amperes current will be flowing through entire circuit. 0.8 amps will flow through 10 ohms and 5 ohms series network, and 0.8 amps will flow across 15 ohms. Okay. Now, voltage across 15 ohms will be equal to 12 volts. Voltage across 3 ohms will be equal to 4.8 volts. Voltage across 2 ohms resistance will be equal to 3.2 volts. Now, voltage across 10 ohms will be equal to 8 volts, and voltage across 5 ohms will be equal to 4 volts. So, you have found out the current through and voltage across entire elements in this network. Okay. Let's move to the next question, which is two heaters rated at 1000 watt 250 volt each are connected in series across 250 volts 50 hertz AC main. The total power drawn by the supply will be, so let's make the circuit first. Okay. We will have a heater over here and another heater over here connected in series across 250 volts 50 hertz AC supply. Okay. As you know that the rating of both resistances are same. Therefore, the total resistance of heater will be equal to V square by P, which will be equal to 250 into 250 upon 1000, which will be equal to 62.5 ohms. So, 62.5 ohms resistance of each resistor will be connected with each other in series. Okay. So, net resistance of this particular circuit will be equal to 125 ohms. So, net power loss will be equal to V square upon Req. As you know that P equal to V square by R. So, V is 250 into 250 upon 125, which will be equal to 500 watts. Okay. So, such kind of questions is asked in SSC-JE, GATE and other competitive exams. Okay. Let's move to the next question. In this question, we have to find the voltage across 1 ohm resistor using KCL. So, we have to find out this voltage. Let us say it is V1. Okay. So, as per KCL, we have to assign the voltage at nodes. Let us assume this is V1 and this is your Vx. Okay. So, apply KCL at node 1. So, 10 amps will be equal to, see, this current and this current are leaving and this current is incoming. So, incoming will be equal to outgoing current, and this is your reference point which is grounded. So, voltage across this particular node will be equal to 0 volt. So, current through this 1 ohm resistance will be equal to V1 minus 0, the potential difference upon net resistance, okay, plus current through this particular 2 ohm resistance will be equal to V1 minus Vx upon 2. Okay, now, so let's solve this particular equation. So we will get 2 V1 plus V1 minus Vx upon 2 equal to 10. 20 will be equal to 3 V1 minus Vx. Okay, now, at node X, apply KCL. In this case, the current is coming from this direction and leaving into two direction. Okay, so the incoming current will be equal to V1 minus Vx upon 2. Okay, outgoing current will be equal to Vx minus 0 upon 4, the potential difference across 4 ohm resistance, and upon the net resistance, plus 5, which is also leaving, okay, plus Vx minus 0 upon 4. So, we will get V1 minus Vx upon 2 equal to 2 into Vx upon 4 plus 5. So, equation will be V1 minus Vx upon 2 minus Vx by 2 equal to 5. So, equation was V1 minus Vx upon 2 minus Vx upon 2 equal to 5. 2 V1 minus Vx minus Vx equal to 5. So, V1 minus 2 Vx equal to 10. This will be your equation 2, and previous equation was this particular equation. So, using equation 1 and 2, we have to find out the value of V1 and Vx. So, from 1, Vx will be equal to 3V1 minus 20. So, from equation number 2, we will get V1 minus 2 into 3V1 minus 20 equal to 10. Again, solving this particular equation, V1 minus 6V1 plus 40 equal to 10. Minus 5V1 equal to minus 30, then V1 equal to 6 volts. So, this is how we can use KCL to find out the current through and voltages across any element. Okay, let's move to the next question. In this question, we have to find out the equivalent capacitance across A and B. Okay, so this circuit has three parts. First one is this part, second is this one, and third one is this one. Okay, now, first of all, we are going to solve this particular part separately. Okay, so let's go with third part, in which we have two capacitors connected in parallel . One of them is of 50 microfarad, another one is 25 microfarad. As you know that in parallel the capacitors gets added directly, so net capacitance will be equal to 25 plus 50 equal to 75 microfarad. Now, let's move to this particular network first, in which we have three capacitors. Two of them are connected in series, which is 10 microfarad and 5 microfarad, and another one is connected in parallel, which is 1 microfarad. So, As you know that in series, the capacitance is added in this way. 1 upon C Eq, Cs Eq will be equal to 1 upon 10 plus 1 upon 5, which will be equal to 10, 1 plus 2. So, C equivalent will be equal to 10 by 3 microfarad. Okay. Now, this particular network is connected in parallel with this particular network. So, the C1 will be equal to 1 plus 10 by 3, which will be equal to 13 by 3 microfarad. Okay. Now, let's compile these networks. So, we will have 3 capacitors connected in series with each other across A and B. One of them will be of 13 by 3 microfarad, another one will be equal to 20 microfarad, and other one will be equal to 75 microfarad. Okay, so capacitance will be equal to 1 upon 13 by 3 plus 1 upon 20 plus 1 upon 75. So, 3 by 13 plus 1 upon 20 plus 1 upon 75. So, this will be equal to 0.23 plus 0.05 plus 0.013, which will be 0.293. Okay. So, 1 upon C Eq equal to 0.293. So, C equivalent will be equal to 1 upon 0.293, which will be equal to 3.14 microfarad. So, C equivalent across the AB is equal to 3.14 microfarad in total. Okay. So, this will be all. In next lecture, we will learn about nodal, mesh and other various network theorems which are very important in SSC-JE, GATE and IES syllabus and other electrical exams as well. So, please watch, like, subscribe. Thank you.